Senator Serrano to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. And I do also want to echo the sentiments of many of my colleagues and applauding the governor on having the intestinal fortitude to recognize and tackle an issue that is obviously very daunting. And while I will vote yes on this bill, I do have a certain level or many reservations. I grew up in the 1970s in the South Bronx. A lot of people in this chamber can't say that they did that. And I saw what a fiscal downturn and what mismanagement from a financial standpoint can do to communities. And what was happening in the South Bronx was happening all throughout the state. And what I learned from that, and now what I believe as an elected official, is that if you really want to lose population, if you really want to lose the core base that you want to keep in any state or any city, is you cut services to the point that people feel unsafe and they don't feel that they are protected. So I believe that the way that we go forward with this, and while I agree that this is just one step, I am not happy with the cuts that we are enacting here today, but going forward, as we continue to tackle this problem, we cannot ignore the fact that, as Senator Perkins said, we must share the pain and spread the pain in a much more equitable fashion to avoid the mistakes that were made in the 1970s. And if we do not create that fair and equitable tax system, which many people are afraid to talk about, we will continue to have this disparity that exists now. So when I hear people say, well, if we tax too much, then the rich will leave. Well, where are they going to go? Boise, Idaho? No offense to Boise, Idaho, but I think that they are in New York because they want to be in New York, because New York is the greatest state in the world, in the country. So I think it's important that we really not be mystified by that process. And remember that people are here because of the services that we provide. The minute we start cutting those services to a point that they are no longer effective is when we will lose the very population and tax base that we want to keep. So I ask my colleagues to, as we move forward in this process, to not only look for ways to cut, and I think we've cut as far as we can go, and we need to start looking for ways to turn around these cuts, but we have to look to create a fair tax system where the very wealthy in the state, who are protected enormously by tax loopholes and by shelters, that they do their fair share, as all of us are doing more than our share. I will vote yes.